Bienvenidos. Welcome, everybody. We're going to get started in about 5 minutes. Vamos a comenzar dentro de unos 5 minutos. Estamos preparando todo. We're getting everything ready for an incredible 3 classes today. Do you believe that?
Believe it.
I believe it. Quiero decir. Feedback. Okay. I need a point. Hola. Let's see. Tun, tun, tun. Checking it out. Hold on. I can't see. Can you move a little bit to the side? Just so I can see. Uh-huh. That's perfect for our viewers. Beautiful. Testing. Welcome, everybody. We're gonna get started in about 2 minutes. Get ready to spin. Testing 1, 2, 1, 2. Making sure everybody's doing well. We're gonna get started. Make sure you have some water. Okay. Bienvenidos, welcome everybody. We're gonna get started in our class today of doing spins and turns. Now this is part 2 of what I have done before last week. If you don't catch anything that you've seen today and it doesn't make sense, please go to part 1, which is also on the list of all the videos that we've been doing all week and practically almost a month doing this, huh? Isn't that crazy? Well, bienvenidos a todos. Hoy vamos a trabajar en giros y vamos a trabajar cómo lo podemos usar con la pareja. Y si en realidad no entienden algo, porque esta es la parte 2 de los giros, tenemos la parte 1 en la lista también que grabamos la semana pasada. Bienvenidos a todos otra vez, de todo corazón, se los agradezco por estar con nosotros. I appreciate all of you being with us today. I hope all of you are healthy and still washing your hands. Where are we being visited from?
Well,
let's see.
We've got a lot of holas.
Holas.
Hi, Vincent, Arturo, Lucky, Antonio, Norma, Nicolás. Hi. Oh, hi, thank you. I enjoyed watching every single class with you. Thank you, Norma.
Gracias. Thank you. If the microphone or anything doesn't sound well, please let us know in the chat. Mm-hmm. We're trying our best to do the best quality that we can for you.
See?
Again, we're dancers and not video people, but we're making it work and it's beautiful. Yes.
Saludos de Italia, Francia. Escondido. Esco. What's up, Esco?
Italia. Okay. Vamos a comenzar y
We're
gonna get ready, Palestine.
Okay, sorry, I know, I wanna keep
the world, Mexico. We're gonna get started.
So
I wanna say again, thank you for joining us. Today we have 3 classes. Please stick around for a bunch of fun stuff we're gonna do. Now, some of you, I don't know if you remember, we worked with a buddy of mine, his name is Roger. And I don't know if any of you have been able to go get your Rogers, but we're gonna get started with that. This is something that we use on the first class, and I have my modelo, Serena Cuevas, everybody. Wow!
Okay.
Gracias. Okay. This is Roger. Este es un palo de escoba que me ayuda mucho para aprender los giros. This is how we're going to work a little bit. We're going to remember some of the details that we were talking about last week was how important it is to keep your balance. Now, when you dance, you tend to do this, or when you throw your arms to get into a spin or a turn, you tend to do that. Now, what Roger's going to do for us is to make us conscious of what we're doing with our arms and where our arm placement is and hand placement.
La razón por qué estoy usando la escoba es para que en realidad estemos conscientes de lo que estamos haciendo con los brazos y con las manos cuando damos giros.
Let's get started. Remember, if I do salsa on one, if I step forward, 1, 2, 3. The idea is that I'm going to work from the ground up. Stepping my one, I'm going to pivot, pivote, 2. Now keeping my hands in front, 2, facing the audience, and then I'm going to pivot and turn on 3. Now notice where my arms and my hands are. They're on the left side. It isn't until 5 that I go 5, 6, 7. What happens is a lot of us, when we're doing turns, we bring our arms together, and now look where the balance is, and now I have to work hard to come back to center. So it's very important that we make sure that we understand this. Now, this is what I call helium hands, okay? Helium hands is when your hands tend to go up. Has that ever happened when you're dancing? Yes, keep it where your belly button is.
Bien importante que cuando estamos practicando los giros, las vueltas, es bien importante cerrar los pasos, el 1, el 2. Mantengo todo al lado izquierdo, todo el centro, todo donde está mi gente. 2 y 3. Perdí el balance. Ahora, si hago esto, camino, camino y camino.
If I think of walking, I have a better chance of not losing my balance. If I think of spinning, I will have a greater chance of losing my balance. It's just a whole mind game, okay? So think of walking.
Piensa en caminar, porque si piensa en giros, el balance se le va a ir. Realmente camino, 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 camino. Ahora, 5, 6, 7.
If I were to do this on 2, okay, let's do it on the men's timer. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Let's do it facing the opposite way. Lo vamos a probar. On 1, remember, we're going to go again, keeping this in the center. We're going to go 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Perfect. Now if I do it on 2, men's timing, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Now, very important that we understand we must breathe. Remember, if you do not breathe, you're going to create tension. If you create tension, it's going to kill your movement, okay? Tension is the killer of all movement. Understand that. So you must breathe.
Lo que estoy explicando ahorita es que tienen que respirar, porque si no, van a crear tensión. Y si hacen tensión en su cuerpo, van a matar el movimiento de todo su cuerpo. Bien importante que necesitan respirar.
It's very important that you breathe. So, I'm doing this bilingual because it's very important that everybody understands the best that they can. So,
lo estoy siendo bilingüe porque quiero que todos tengan la oportunidad de aprender esto. Y si, espero que entiendan mi español. Pero aquí vamos.
Okay, so as we do this, remember, Roger's going to help us. We can also bring it, and we talked about this at the beginning. Now, this is helping me keep my frame, and I use this all the time as I go 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. And remember, I'm just going to go over this just a little bit. You must train the balls of the inside of your feet. A lot of us tend to walk on our outside of our feet. Realize this, if your shoes are looking like they're leaning towards the outside, then we know you're doing something bad. So you must bring in all that energy, all of your strength through the inner of your legs, okay? And as we do that, I'm going to do it from this side. As I'm walking, recuérdense que van a caminar marcando el 1, 2 y 3. 5, 6, 7. Siempre poniendo presión a los pies. Y a la misma vez levantando la cabeza. So make sure you're pressing down to go up, if that makes sense to you. All right. How are we doing? Okay. ¿Todos bien? ¿Questions? Si tienen preguntas, por favor, póngalo ahí. Serena nos va a ayudar con eso. Now, I'm going to work on also the right turn with a hook. A lot of you were like, wow, that was crazy. I thought you were spinning. This is not a spin. This is a turn.
Ahora lo que voy a enseñarles es algo que enseñé la semana pasada que se llama, son dos vueltas, pero no son giros. Realmente es eso.
Let's take a look at it. It's going to go 1, 2, 3. Then I step hook, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7.
Let me do this from this angle. Lo vamos a hacer de esta manera. Vamos a marcar el 1, 2, 3, 5, pero no bajo el talón. I do not drop my heel. 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3. If I go a little bit faster, un poco más rápido. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1.
Now, very important that we also practice spotting, okay? Spotting is not going to cure you being dizzy, but it's going to help you realize where you need to go, okay?
Es bien bonito y es importante practicar el spotting, ¿ok? Porque tiene que uno siempre ver a dónde va a terminar. Por ejemplo, me explico, vengo yo aquí, poco a poco.
This is how I practice my spotting, everybody. I do like little merengue steps. Notice where my head stays, my body's still going. And then towards the end, I'm looking towards where I'm going to go. Now, if I do that on the other side, practice this. And the quicker you do it, notice that I'm breathing through it. Good. This is going to help you on your spins and turns in the future. Okay. As we're doing this, and I'm moving along because we've done this already in the other classes.
Estoy moviendo un poco más rápido en esta sesión, porque ya lo había explicado anteriormente en el otro video.
Now we're going to work on some drills for spins. Okay. Let's keep the Roger. Let's do the Roger. So one way that we can practice this, remember, the difference between a spin and a turn is a weight of change compared to just being on one. Yes.
Change of weight.
Sorry?
Change of weight.
That's what I said. So as I'm here, I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Notice that I'm just taking, don't take huge steps. Don't let them go past your shoulders. Keep everything underneath you. And that is important. That's one of the biggest keys I said in the class before, that you must remain, everything has to be underneath you. So as we step 1, notice how I'm turning out my right knee in that direction that I'm going through, so it makes it easier for me to get around and spot for the other side. Now, if I practice that, remember, my arms are not going up or down, and I'm trying to keep my balance. Also, I'm breathing. So I'm going to go 5, 6, and 7.
Okay? Let's practice that. This is a great exercise for you to try at home. Okay? Notice that I'm not doing this. I'm not throwing my arms to get there. Okay? Now, it's very important, if we go here, okay, that I can also do behind my back. Okay? Here we go. We're going to go. One, two, and three. Five, six, and seven. One, two, three, five, six, seven. Okay. So without Roger, now you've graduated to not using Roger. Woohoo! I'm wearing my favorite color today, orange. So if I'm here at the same spot, I'm going to step one. Notice that everything is right underneath me, okay? As I'm stepping to the side, everything's right underneath me. I want you to make sure that you're not doing this, because now we're in trouble. Now you're gonna have to work harder to get on that, to get on the other side. So, as we step, one, pivot two, three, keeping my arms. Five, six. Now this is something we talked about last time, CBM, contra body movement, as I'm going in that preparation. And notice that they stay on that right side until I'm ready to go one, two, three. So if I go one, two, I'm twisting over to my left to go to my right. And then same thing, five, six, seven. One, two, three. As we graduate, I want you to also understand, okay? And I talked about this in my other class, and a lot of people wrote me, wow, Nery, that changed everything for me. Lo que estamos hablando ahorita es algo de que en realidad enseñé en la otra clase que cambió la manera de cómo la gente está pensando cómo dar giros. All right, so let's bring Roger back. So make sure, if I'm looking at Roger, Roger's 12 o'clock, okay? Roger es como un reloj, son las 12 para mí. 3 o'clock, 3. 6 o'clock, 6, 6. 9 o'clock, and back to 12. When I'm turning or spinning, we always think, oh, I need to look at the 12 o'clock. I always say, if you're going to your right, you must look at least an hour before you arrive. So that means I want you looking at 11 o'clock. Instead of looking at Roger, this is my partner in front of me, I know I'm going to my right, so in order to arrive, I will stop at 11 o'clock, okay? So if I'm turning, 11 o'clock is where I'm going to stop, so momentum can bring me to 12 o'clock. Okay, me explico ahorita. Lo que estoy hablando es que cuando yo estoy bailando con una persona, realmente estoy viendo que la persona es, si fuera un reloj, fuera las 12. Pero si yo me voy a la derecha con un giro, tengo que ver a las 11. Para llegar a tiempo, y después con tiempo llego a las 12. Me explico, si voy aquí, son las 12, pero sé que tengo que llegar, voy y busco las 11, para después que el movimiento me lleve a las 12. What happens is, a lot of times, when we're looking at the person that we want to spot or spin, we overturn, now we have to work hard to get back there. Has that ever happened to you? It's happened to me many times. So it's very important that if I'm looking at my partner, that I arrive early. Now, if I'm going to my left, I'm going to end up at 1 o'clock. So if you are the camera, I'm looking for 1 o'clock. If I'm going to my left, I arrive here at 1, so then I can adjust myself easily to come towards you. But if I'm looking towards you and I'm going there, what happens is now my body has passed 12 o'clock and is going towards 11 o'clock. I know this is a lot of information, but I want you to understand that that's how my mind works. Okay, so if I'm going to borrow Serena Cuevas, okay?
That's me.
That's her. I'm just going to explain myself on how all this works, especially when I'm doing right turns with a hook. Okay, vamos a usar a Serena Cuevas. Hola, Serena. Okay. 11, 1. 11, 1.
Sí.
So, if I'm practicing, if estoy practicando, básico, doy para la derecha, I'm going to look for that shoulder. Boom. Now I'm center. If I'm going to go to my left, and it doesn't matter if I do a left turn, I'm going to look for that shoulder so I can line up with it. Okay? Now, if I'm connected, y hago una colita. Nice. I'm always looking for her shoulders to see where I'm going to finish. If I do it the other way, perfect. I try not to do it in the center, so that way I don't lose my balance. Okay. Now, if I'm going to do a right turn with a hook, I'm going to go right here, hook. I'm already looking for her left shoulder or her right shoulder, and I'm already aligned. It's perfect, so when you're doing anything like this, you can go right into a crossbody lead and move into it. Okay? Perfect. Gracias, Serena. Thank you very much. Bien importante, siempre estoy buscando los hombros de ella y no trato de buscar siempre el centro. Do we have any questions before I get started on my other stuff?
Vincent, why dance with Roger when Serena is in the room?
That's right. Well, it's Serena's not in everybody.
Hello, everyone. Lots of hello, lots of love from France, from Spain, from West LA.
What?
Okay, Nicolas, my appreciation for this 11 o'clock spotting is unspeakable.
Wow. Who was this?
Nicolaus.
Yes, it changed everything for me.
Awesome. Saludos de Chicago. Okay.
So I also want to tell you that when you're practicing this, only practice 5 to 10 minutes. I don't want you doing this for an hour. Por favor, si van a practicar esto, háganlo por 5 o 10 minutos. No lo hagan por una hora porque se van a cansar y después lo van a hacer mal. Then you're going to do it, and you're going to do it wrong because you're tired. Okay, let's try it to some music. But if we have a question, let's go right ahead.
Okay, so one question before music. Thank you, Sebastian, for asking the question. Sebastian asks, do you have tips for spins with lifting your feet from the ground? Like maybe, I think maybe you mean like passe or coupe, or you know, sometimes when you bring your foot up. Yeah, maybe if that's not what you're asking, Sebastian, then just write it one more time for me, a little
more detail. Because there's ways.
There's so many ways
to do these, but all of that is from really working from your calves and really pressing up. So there's a lot to that, but we'll incorporate some of that for you. Serena wants to play us some music because she loves the music.
Can't help myself.
She's a DJ. So we're going to try a nice little exercise on how you're going to practice. Vamos a practicar, vamos a poner una canción y les voy a enseñar cómo quiero que practiquen. Y let's do it, Serena.
All right.
Make sure you choose a slow song, everybody, to do this. Muy importante.
Yes. All right, here we go.
Lo de nosotros fue un impulso, una atracción. Fue un buen momento y el momento ya pasó. Fue un cuerpo a cuerpo, de sexo a sexo. Pero lo nuestro era un deseo, no era amor. Y muchas veces se confunde la
entender la situación.
Lo que pasó entre tú y yo pasó.
Yeah. Epa, de lado.
Debes entender
lo que pasó.
No fue mi intención.
Entre tú y yo.
Good. Beautiful. None of this. Ah, gracias.
None of this is actually spins. This is all turns. Preguntas.
Okay. So, I just want to say, I'm so happy everybody's asking the questions. It's really awesome. And everyone loved the song. They were like, sí, la música. Everything great. So I put the title of the song in there. If you didn't catch it, it is typed in there. It says, Lo que pasó entre tú y yo pasó by Luis Enrique.
Uy.
So you can check that out. And Sebastian re-questioned, which was sí. Awesome. And he says he's talking about when you kick and spin, or you have a spin with a kick.
Wow.
That could be anything. That could be fuerte turns in ballet. It could be, but I've seen, I think I know too, like, like the Chuck step. I mean, there's so many things.
There is. You know what? Guys, I could,
we gotta
believe
keep,
me, we
keep
we,
trying on that one.
I have instructional videos for all this stuff. And so what I'm trying to do today is actually give you the foundation of all this stuff. And don't worry, all those things will come together. And in the Q&A, if you find a video that deals with that, what I'm doing, please let
Friday.
Me know on the Q&A. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Also, Sebastian, I really appreciate this. He says, thank you for taking the time to answer all questions. Nobody else does this.
Well, that's the purpose of why we're doing this.
Right.
So Sebastian is, you know, making sure that we are all learning. So es bueno que en realidad me hagan preguntas, porque si solo les doy la información y no hacen preguntas, en realidad no estoy haciendo mi trabajo. Muchas gracias por las preguntas, Sebastian. Okay.
And then lastly, thank you, Galen, for asking a question. He says, is it okay and not rude to spot the ground, as it helps him feel less dizzy? So, I mean, I would say it's okay, like, right now, but you do want to be practicing so that you have your eye level.
Right.
But if it helps you right now just to get a sense of it, try it low, and then try it a few feet up, try like a chair height, then try like a table
still
height.
Up a little bit.
Yeah, so, I mean, you do want to graduate yourself up to what is proper technique, but there's nothing wrong with it. You know, if it's helping you, give it a go.
The other thing is that, let me tell you something, when you are looking down, you're also bringing your body with you. Okay, and that's off balance. Think of a guy that's walking a tightrope, and he looks down, he's going down, unfortunately. So I want to make sure that, yes, you can look down, but your vision, look at this, all of my postures are correct, but if my vision's looking down, okay, but if I'm actually looking down, ahí vamos. Lo que estoy explicando ahorita es que si la gente quiere ver para abajo, quiero que entiendan que van la estructura, la postura de uno, se les va a caer y le va a ser más difícil para hacer estos giros, para dar las vueltas. Tienen que entender que todo está aquí. Ahora, si la vista baja un poco para ver a dónde voy, no está malo, pero no se lleven la cabeza. Okay, so moving on, we're going to get started into how can we incorporate these moves. Ahora vamos a usar estos giros, estas vueltas, ¿cómo los podemos usar? But before that, let's put another song on and we're going to get warmed up with some spins. Vamos a ahora poner una canción para trabajar en los giros. ¿Cómo van a practicar? Vamos ahí. Doble. Listo. Serena me quiere matar hoy.
Oh, you want to
I can do it, but you know.
Okay, let's.
I still got two other classes to teach.
Let's see what we got here.
Now, the other thing.
Concern.
Work on your core. Tienen que trabajar en el estómago.
With me, Saturday, a las 11.
Porque esto es lo que ayuda. Okay, so as we do this, all we're going to practice, try it real quick before you put the song on. Please do not push off, because what we talked about, and Serena talked about this in her class, is you're not trying to push off to go up, okay? If it happens, I get it. We call that pedaling. Es bien importante que cuando comiencen a dar giros, por favor, no empujen del pie, digamos, el pie derecho, para dar la vuelta, porque después vamos arriba en vez de dar la vuelta entero. So make sure that everything is underneath you. Remember, it's your arms that are going to work with you. Look how tight I keep everything. Okay, in my spot. Nice. Vamos.
Una,
¿sí?
Una pregunta en español.
Okay.
Okay.
Una pregunta en español.
Okay.
Vamos, Serena, you can do it.
I can do it. All right. Cuando giras entonces, mm-hmm. tienes que estar estirando. That's the first part.
Okay.
And the second part is, hay gente que dice que tienes que flexionar las piernas.
Sí. Las, wow, Serena, tu español está increíble ahora.
Gracias. Me gusta leer.
¿De quién fue?
De Bettino.
Bettino. Sí, es bien importante que hay que estirar, ¿sí? Siempre, it's very important. He's asking if it's important to stretch. Yes, I'm pulling up to press down. I'm trying to be the tallest version of myself. Estoy tratando de ser la persona más alta en ese cuarto. Y la otra cosa es, sí, mantener eso. Y también, don't lock your legs. Don't lock your knees. When you're turning, don't lock them. No hay que estirar las piernas y ponerlas como en un lock. Es verdad, hay que tenerla suave. You gotta keep them soft. So when you're doing these, you're keeping this soft, bent. But I don't want you getting small. I used to do that as well. So there is a balance to that. Okay, Serena, let's put a song on because we have a lot to do right now. But I love these questions. Gracias.
Makes you turn and then when you're back to 11 and ending at 1:30, ha ha ha, because the guy moved. So Leslie, anytime if the guy is leading a turn or he's making an effort or he's doing spins and you're doing spins, look, we have to go with the flow. Whatever happens in that moment, you know, I'm sure he's doing his best, I'm sure he's trying, I'm sure you're trying too. So you just want to focus on spotting, focus on balance, you know, and just have a good time. Things are always going to happen. There's always times I dance with people and it's perfect. And then there's times I dance with people and my spins will be off or how I feel is off or maybe I'm stopping at 1:30, you know. So just got to enjoy it and keep practicing. The more you practice, the more your rate of progression goes up and the better both of you will be. So hopefully that helps.
Okay, great questions. So there's a lot that's going to happen while you're dancing. And you do understand that this is a practice that has to happen pretty much every day. I practice these every day. Even till now, I still practice them because I don't want to lose it. Lo que estoy hablando ahorita es que es bien importante que tenemos que practicar todo esto porque si no lo practicamos, lo perdemos. Y yo todavía, después de 19 años, todavía lo practico esto todos los días. Okay, I'm gonna get going. And so, as we did all those, now we're going to incorporate. I'm gonna give you 5 different ways you can add spins and turns, even crazy stuff into your dancing. And with that, I'm going to ask the beautiful Serena Cuevas to join us. Everybody give it up to Serena Cuevas.
Be right back. That's me. Be right back. BRBs.
Bienvenidos. Bienvenido. Okay. Vamos. Okay.
So we were practicing. Vamos a probar diferentes maneras en cómo podemos usar los giros y las vueltas en pareja. We're going to try this with partner. So the first one is what something that we do every single time is a cross partida. Algo que hacemos siempre es un dile que no. Ahora, how do we add a turn to a cross body lead? Check this out. 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3. 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3. 5, 6, 7. 1. Notice she's just doing a cross body lead. And I can mask that by putting it to my hand. See that? What? Now we're bending. Using the head, now the neck. Same move. Then I want to use my waist. How do I do that? Ah, colita. See, three moves using the same footwork. Colita. Pero mi gente, I have another hand. I have another hand. Tengo otra mano. Check it out. Check it out. We're going to go 1, 2, 3. Mira esto. Now I'm going to use this. I'm in open position. Estoy en abierto. Ahora estoy usando el mismo movimiento, pero en abierto. ¿Qué puedo hacer? Ajá. And I'm going to use this with the neck. Boom. Nice. And I can go into another move. Smooth. Ahora, dos colitas. Dos colitas. Boom. There we go. Es una práctica. Okay? It's beautiful because at the same time, I'm just using a crossbody lead. I'm using what the fifth part is my 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3. And as you get better, okay, I'm going to move on. Voy a usar esto, pero bien importante, cuando uso el dile que no, 1, 2, 3. She goes first. Please, do not do the turn as she's coming, because you will hit her. Make sure that she goes first. Es bien importante que ella esté allá al otro lado antes de hacer la vuelta. 1, 2, 3, ella va. 5, voy yo. 6, 7. I turn on 6, 7. If you go on 5, I swear to you, you're going to hit it.
You have to lead me first, guys, because it's like you're communicating to tell me what to do first, and now I'm good to go, and you don't have to worry about it because I'm on my way. Next, then you take action, and you do your move, and you're in the clear. You don't have to think about me. You're just good to go, too. So it's really nice. You take care of her. You deliver the communication, and then do 6 spins or whatever. It's great.
So remember, I'm using my head, my neck, my waist, all these moves to create something different, okay? Now, tailbone, now moving on, doing a tailbone with a hook turn. We did this on the first video. Hicimos esto en el primer video. You can change it up. You can go, I go, under. 1. Notice I use the same formula. Arriba, colita. Yeah? I can use the same formula. Nuca, colita. Yeah? So you what you're doing is you're using the same footwork that you've been taught and now applying it to head, neck, and waist. And that's how I build up my moves. There you go. Now, because I'm very limber, when I was doing the tailbone with a hook, I came up with this one. Okay? So, bien importante, if you practice this, and I'm doing this because a lot of you ask me, how do you do that?
Everybody's probably right now. Wow! Nery, teach that one!
Es bien importante, la razón por qué hice esto es para que vean que hay diferentes maneras que uno puede construir. Comencé arriba, ahora me fui abajo, dije, ahora voy a construir algo bien bonito. Como yo estiro tanto, vamos. Y sigo. Now, notice I did not do this, and I see people do this all the time. It does not have the same thing.
You're moving me, not moving.
Don't do that. This has to stay. If you're going to choose to keep it there, it stays there.
Limbo.
It stays. See that? Y wow.
I almost did the splits.
Casi. Casi. Okay, and I'm spotting her the whole time. Ahora, en eso, gracias. Serena, gracias Serena. Lo que estoy haciendo ahorita es que como si dejé yo la mano aquí, la regla es que no la voy a levantar para hacer ese lujo. La mantengo aquí, perdón. Voy yo aquí, la mantengo, hago el hook y yo bajo. Woo! 40 years old, y'all. 40. 40 tengo y todavía. Woo! Okay. Now, as I was doing these are practices that you can do. The other one, this is all turns. Todas estas son vueltas, no son giros. Now, one that I used to do a lot was within Chufle. When I would go 1, 2, 3, hook, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Bring your back. Same in Chufle, I can go 1, 2, 3, let go, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Same footwork. What else can I make from that footwork? 1, 2, 3, both hands. 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Lo que quiero que entiendan que estoy haciendo la misma figura, pero con diferentes partes del cuerpo. La cabeza, ¿verdad? Pum, cabeza. Pum, cintura. Puedo ir aquí. Pum. ¿Ah? So I'm using the same formula for all these things, okay? Very important that you keep the technique always. Because if you do something like this, you don't look at it, and you do this, now we're in trouble. So you must, please, please, not make her fear that you can't do a turn.
Big trouble.
Big troubles, okay? Okay, the other one that I want you to practice, and I'm giving you a bunch that you're gonna work on, is that it's a crossbody, now with a hook, turn. Woo! Okay? We did this before. 1, 2, 3. Arriba. Abajo. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Now that's called the over and under with a crossbody lead. Okay? Now the beauty about this is that you're training yourself constant to spot it, to look where your footwork is. Everything is underneath. Okay? Good. Now, let's try that to some music.
Let's do it.
Vamos a ver cómo trabaja con música. And now, after that, we're going to do some spins. And then we are done. Okay? Música, por favor. I'm giving it today.
Stand by.
Hoy lo voy a dar todito. Wow.
Let's see. Change it up on Nery here. Let's see what he thinks about this.
Serena, I need you.
Okay.
Sí, Serena.
Great. Great.
They're loving it. ¿Les gusta?
Everybody's ¿Sí o no? Loving it.
You're loving it? All right. Here we go. So, giros, very important. How are you going to practice your spins? One way, we talked about it last video. One, two, three, measuring. Five, six, seven, one. That's in our first video. Now, how can I incorporate this? You're going to try to go for that double. Now, the beauty about it is that I got a trick to this. When I go one, two, three, five, six, notice I'm already spotting her on six. All I have to do, seven, one. And it looks like I'm doing two, but I'm already doing one and a half by the time I'm spotting for that six. So, lo que estoy diciendo, el truco aquí, cuando marco el cinco, cinco, seis, ya terminé mitad de mi giro, siete, un, dos, tres. Por eso se ve que estoy dando como dos o tres giros, pero en realidad, I'm spotting on six. Estoy spotting en el six. Ahora, ahora lo voy a hacer dos y media, okay? And this is what you want to go and maybe you can reach. Two, three, five, six, seven, one, two, three, five, six, seven. Now, if you cannot do one, don't go for two. Real quick, if you can, and you're going for it, and you're falling off balance, then it's not worth it. You have to train yourself to at least do one correct. Okay? If we do it this way, I'm here. Okay. So as I'm here, one, two, three. I set my five, six. Look, I got my preparation going. Six, I let go six. Seven, eight, one, two, three. Okay? Now, when you're doing this, make sure that you're not stepping too far from your five, underneath, five, six, seven, eight, and one, okay?
And leaves, he's already opening up the line across body leaves, like you can see me. So he's spinning in front of me, and at the very end, opening up and clearing the space. So that's very valuable because it sets me up for right away where I need to be, and that also gives him another two beats to play with spins and is already open by three. So I should be ready to go. Follows you should be ready to go for that crossbody lead of whatever type it is. But if he's already open by three, that's perfect because he's cleared the way and it's my turn.
And now I'm also going to do it on two real quick. So one, two, three, five, six, seven. One, two, three, five, six, seven. One, two, three, five, six, seven. One, two, three. Five, six, seven, one, two, three, five. Remember to breathe, tienen que respirar, okay? Now, how do I incorporate this with other moves? I'll show you two other ways that I use spins, and we can do virtual classes to...
Spin part three, okay?
No, we'll do part seven and a half. So this one's called the copa. One, two, and three. I step in five, same way, six, seven, grab. One, two, three, five, six, seven. En el dos, ¿cómo fue esto? Esto se llama una copa con un hammerlock. Venimos, perdón, like that. Mm-hmm. One, two, three, así mismo. Ok, con la mano derecha, mano izquierda de ella, abro. One, two, three. Nadie. Five. Six, seven, one, two, three. Si lo hago en el dos, marco en el seis. Six, seven, one, two, three, five. Six, seven, one, two, three, five. I swear to you, you pull this on the dance floor, you will stand out more than most leads because a lot of these guys are not doing this anymore. It used to be big, but then it just stopped. So you can't, you don't have to stop, okay? You can be... the new guy in town. The last one I'm going to show you, okay? And it's the last one for now. Woo! Man, I'm late.
No. Respira.
Woo! Es mucho trabajo. Okay. Ahora, cuando vengo yo aquí, okay, I can go aquí. Now, there's the other version where I can go into more of an LA look. This is a hook with a turn. So if I go one, two, three, instead of stepping my five forward, I'm going to hook five, six. Now I'm prepping for seven, eight. One, two, three. So now I'm going to my right side of this. Now you saw me do something with my hands. I'm here, boom, boom, keeping it. Hey, what's going on? Be careful that this doesn't throw you off balance. The best way to actually learn this is to keep everything centered. Boom. And then from there you can go into another move. ¿Sí? Serena, con una canción. ¿Probamos?
Sí.
En uno y en dos. Y después terminamos porque tenemos otra clase. Whew. Man, I think this vest is a little tight on me. I can't breathe. No, spinning is a lot of work. It is a lot of work. Thank you guys, bienvenidos a todos. Gracias otra vez. Les agradezco, estoy cansadísimo. Pero realmente, por favor, ven el video, practiquen mucho, pero ten conciencia, sean conscientes de lo que están practicando. Respirando, spotting, los pies, todo. Yes, Serena.
Awesome. Okay, just real quick. So, I just want to say some things.
Please say.
Okay, so, oh my gosh, so many great things. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, thank you, thank you. First off, there's a question about from Red. Hi, my name is Sherry. Will there be a spin technique video for ladies? And yes, there is. Hi, Sherry. There already are. There's two so far. There's going to be a third one coming up this Saturday. Say what? And it's Saturday at noon Pacific time. So the same class time slot, but it's gonna be on my channel on Deseo Studios. So follow me, I'm in the chat. You can just click on me and follow the channel. and then hit the notification bell, and that will set you up for all of my classes this week. And then also,
Serena está hablando que también ella tiene clases en, la, en el canal de ella, a donde ella está enseñando giros para las chicas. Si por favor quieren aprender para las chicas, también pueden ir al canal de ella que se llama Deseo Studios by Serena Cuevas.
And then, so that was that, and everyone says that was great, that we rock, they love it. Hi, Veronica.
Please share it.
Nail.
Share it with people. You think it's going to help. Again, we're doing virtual private lessons. If you guys are interested, let us know, hit us up. I'll leave my information on the page. But we are doing virtual lessons. This is just a little bit of everything that we're teaching, you know. So we're really grateful that we get the chance and the audience to check it out. En realidad estamos, yo sé que es mucha información, pero tenemos clases que estamos dando privadas virtualmente. Si quieren tomar clases en esto, por favor, se pueden comunicar conmigo a través de la cadena aquí. Y realmente es, lo que hemos enseñado es solo un poquito de lo que tenemos de enseñar más.
And just to close it out, I did put the music, that last song by Benny More, and that is in the chat also. If you loved it, those of you asking, thank you for loving it. That's a classic song. Definitely want to have it in your playlist. And then just to close it out, Emilio from Orlando.
Okay. Hi, Emilio.
Hi. He says, guys, you are the number one hot live class in the world. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. We're just trying to get better at it at all times. And thank you again. Again,
we're
going to be on, we're going to log off just for a little bit, because then we're going to jump into our next class,
technique,
which is technique on how to transition from one to dancing on two. So please stick around. Remember, all these things are going to make you just better dancers in general. All right, familia. Gracias otra vez. Tenemos otra clase que viene en unos 5 minutos de cómo de comenzar a bailar al uno y cambiarlo al dos. Por favor, quédense en la cadena y los veo pronto. See ya.